the things which the person already has. That way, we'll be able to boost the confidence of the mentee. After that, help the mentee. H is for help. Help the mentee for the first few speeches. At least till P6, the mentor should be mentoring the mentee with every speech he or she is attending. And mentoring does not mean that you force the person to change the speech, the content of the speech, or ask him to deliver the speech as you would. That is not mentoring. Mentoring is to analyze what he is on the stage and give him the tips about that thing. Do not change the content. If you want to change the organization, do that. But do not change the topic. Do not change the topic or the content or force your thoughts on the person. That would be a kind of rude way. So try to be cooperative enough to entertain the thoughts of the person as well. Now the fourth point is A. Acknowledgement. Like a good mentor, it's your responsibility to make sure that the candidate or your mentee is feeling acknowledged. So make sure you recognize the efforts of the mentee. How you would do that? Perhaps you would be referring that person to further roles, or you would be encouraging the person to go ahead in a few things outside the meeting. For example, if we have a joint meeting or a special session, you can refer that person that, okay, take my mentee, he's good at these things, and you can take that person as an MC, maybe. We keep on holding our CODPs and division level programs. You can refer that person to them. And apart from that, you can also recognize the efforts by small things, maybe a small gesture of a chocolate. Even that would matter. If you feel good, be sure you express that out. After that, E for explore. Now, once your mentee has achieved a level, a certain level with which you are comfortable, then explore more. I remember when I was just 3 months old in Toastmasters, I went to the then PQD and asked directly how to get to the role of air director and division directors. So that was my thought. I'm thankful enough that that person recognized the talent and he told the entire thing to just a newbie. So explore your mentee in that way. Maybe that mentee is capable of many more things. Maybe that mentee is beyond your comfort. So go. And finally, is the F. F for feedback. Constructive feedback. Now, this constructive feedback is a summarization of everything. At every step, you need to give a constructive feedback to your mentee. Now, how? Perhaps if you're finding something useful, or not useful, or not even useful, then do even if you want to acknowledge that person with something. You go ahead and tell them in a very positive language. Like, okay, Harini, you are very fluent with the speech today. Take it as an example. You are very fluent with the speech today, but perhaps if you can use your body language in a better way, it would be much more effective. Because your speech content was something which could be visualized. And if you would express with your hands, maybe the audience would be able to visualize those things. And that would leave an impact on the audience. Or perhaps, like Himanshu, you are a known face in the television. Maybe you can go ahead and step out into the outer world. Maybe you can go and explore more in the division. Maybe you can become the PR person in the division level, at the division level. So that is a way of giving the feedback to your mentee. A positive manner. So these are a few ways with which you can take your mentee to the next level. Now there are a few things which we have to take into consideration. One, your mentee may be a cold call. Perhaps your mentee might not be so good. And the second situation would be, perhaps your mentee is more eligible or more capable than you yourself. At that point of time also, you have to acknowledge it. You have to accept that fact that your mentee is more capable. Perhaps you can direct him to better people, to better leaders, better speakers. I'm not saying to transfer the mentorship, but take the person to the right place. That is also your job. To delegate a person to make sure that your mentee is getting the attention which he wants. That is also your job. And the third situation would be, if you yourself are a mentee, you yourself are a mentee, and the person who's your mentor is a co-worker. So now how do you deal with that? First of all, go ahead and start questioning the people who are in the EC, who is your mentor. Go and ask questions to all of them. In case, I'm sure you'll get a response. In case you don't get a response, then start interacting with the other people as well. You have so many Toastmasters and so many awesome people around you. You will definitely get someone or other to help you. Or the last resort, even if nothing works out, though I'm sure this won't be the case ever, then you have your VP education. You can tell the VP education that I need a dedicated mentor. For this purpose, these are my objectives, this is my learning area. I want to focus on this particular point and I want to mentor to be a second with that. Perhaps you can do that. And finally, as a mentor, if your mentee is a very good speaker and probably he has reached ISC, he has won the ISC at club level, and he's going forward in the area or division or district, then how do you deal with that? Give him proper grilling sessions. I'm sure it must be helpful. So they happen over here as well. So what do? When a person from your club wins at the club level, maybe ISC or Table Topics or Humorous or any other one, and you organize a proper grilling team who will be helping you with the sessions of the mentee, and give them proper feedback by recording the videos. And what you can do is you can record the video, pause and play it at that particular time. Give them proper grilling. So that would be another way of tackling with your mentee. So that was the way of dealing with different kinds of people. Now, what happens as a mentor, at times you feel that your mentee is maybe irritating you or bugging up with questions every day. But people, that is what you are asked for. Toastmasters is totally voluntary. If you feel that you don't have time, if you feel that you are not able to give your best, please, I request you, please tell your VP education that sorry, I will not be able to entertain people right now. I'm currently busy with my office work or somewhere else. But please acknowledge that back to your VP education so that people know that you are occupied with few other things. Alright? So that was how we did the mentor mentee relationship. And of course, everyone knows that when you have a guidance, you are always at a better position, isn't it? So that way, you will be able to tackle many more things in the future. Now, I request you all to, if anyone has any question about this mentor mentee, you can ask them, if anyone has.
So I have a question. When I was a mentee, my major problem was that I was hesitant. Not that the mentor was not receptive or not helping. I don't think we have grown anywhere in the office because of mental coaching. But if I go back to this mentee, what should I do to overcome that hesitation? As a mentee again, to start that all over, how should I overcome the hesitation?
So if I have already completed my entire journey as a Toastmaster, but again, if I have to start, if I, my personal goal is to go for the conference. So if I want to go gyan for those things, I can go forward with the framework, like what my objectives are, I'll note it down, I'll note down my focus areas, and then I will start looking forward to my mentor, or maybe the existing mentor, or maybe someone new whom I aspire, or whom I see as an idol. Then I can go to that person and jot down those things in front of him and focus on that, those particular things. Because you are starting afresh. Anyone else?
So what are the benefits for a mentor apart from the real benefits? What else are the benefits for them?
Okay. So CL credit, trust me friends, that is just a normal thing. I mean, if you have to complete your CL, you will have to ensure that only 3 speeches are done by me. But that is beyond just the 3 credits. When you are a mentor, first of all, learn new things from your mentees. I remember when I was training my mentees, people are very different from you. You get to learn many new things from people. And many times it happens that people shock you. Like, okay, this can also be your case. You get a completely different scenario, different point of view. So that is one thing. Plus, when you see someone preparing in front of you, you get to know about many things which are behind the curtain. And you don't know, you have not, never ever realized them before. That is because when you were a speaker, you used to come on stage and you used to just speak. But as an audience member, I'm sure all of you will agree that as an audience member, we have so many things to point out of the speaker. And when we are on the speaking stage, then we forget them. So when you are a mentor and you have a mentee to cater to, then you get to know many things.
What is the ideal duration in which a mentor and a mentee should be associated?
Okay, so like every other relationship, unlike every other relationship, this one is a very finite relationship. This should be finite every time. And ideally, this should be from P1 to P6 or P10.